Hello friends, welcome to TextStudyCell. In this video, we'll discuss the basic steps of programming the NodeMCU and ESP32 using Arduino IDE. During the video, I will also show you how to check if the ESP32 or NodeMCU is connected with the Wi-Fi or not. And at the end, we'll discuss how to resolve some common error that you may get during programming the ESP32 or NodeMCU board. So let's get started. To program the NodeMCU and ESP32, I will use Arduino IDE. So we can download the Arduino IDE from this page. Again, I will share the link in the description. So I am installing the Arduino IDE in Windows machine. So I'll click here, and you can contribute any amount to Arduino IDE, but I am clicking just download. Now you have to click on save. After downloading the Arduino IDE, you have to install the Arduino IDE. Click on I agree, then next, then just click on install. After installing the Arduino IDE, just open it. After that, you have to go to file, then select preference. Then you have to enter these two URL. So just copy it. You can see this is the URL for ESP32 board, and this is the URL for the ESP8266, which include the NodeMCU. So you just have to copy these two URL, then you have to paste these two URL here, then click on OK. After that, you have to go to tools, then in the board you have to select boards manager, and here you have to search for ESP8266, and you can see for NodeMCU or any other ESP8266 board, you have to install this board. So just click on install, it will install the board. I have already installed it. Now we will install the ESP32 board. So I will search ESP32 here, and you can see to program the ESP32, first you have to install the ESP32 board. Again, I have already installed it. You just have to click install button to install the board. Now let me close it. After installing the board, you have to install the required libraries to program the ESP32 or NodeMCU board. To install the libraries, you have to go to sketch, then include library, then select manage libraries. Now here you can search for any libraries which you want to install. So let me search for Firebase ESP32. Let me install this library. To install it, I just have to click on install, and it will install the library. You can see showing installed, and you can also install any libraries using the zip file. So let me go to the Google Chrome, and let me go to the GitHub page of Adafruit MQTT library. I want to install this library. First, I have to download the library from this button. I'll click on download zip, then save it. So you can see this is the zip file which I will install. Again, I will go to Arduino IDE, then select sketch, include library, and this time I will select add from .zip library, and here I have to browse that zip file. You can see this is the zip file, so I will select it and click on open, and here you can see it's showing library added to your libraries. Check include library menu. So now if I go to sketch, include library, here I should see that library which we have just installed. You can see Adafruit MQTT library. So thus you can install any libraries. Now I will upload this code to NodeMCU board to check if the NodeMCU is connected with the Wi-Fi or not. We don't need any extra libraries for this code, and here you can see you have to mention the Wi-Fi name and the Wi-Fi password. Now let me connect the NodeMCU with the laptop, and as you can see it will print the IP address in the serial monitor, and the baud rate is 115200. Now before uploading the code, I have to select the NodeMCU board. For that, I have to go to tools, then go to board, and here you have to go to ESP8266 board, and then select the NodeMCU 1.0 ESP12B module, then select the proper port. Now I can hit the upload button. The code will first compile, then upload will start, and here you can see it's showing done uploading. So code uploaded successfully. Now I will go to the serial monitor. You can see I have to click on this icon, and here you have to select the baud rate 115200. Then you have to press the reset button of NodeMCU, and you can see it printing the IP address and it also showing Wi-Fi is connected. Thus you can check whether the NodeMCU is connected with the Wi-Fi or not. So now I will enter a wrong Wi-Fi password. As I said, you have to enter the Wi-Fi name here and the Wi-Fi password here. I have intentionally gave the wrong password, so it will not connect with the Wi-Fi. Again, I will upload the code. I am doing this just to show you if the NodeMCU is not connected with the Wi-Fi, how to identify that. Code uploaded successfully. Again, I will open the serial monitor, and again I will press the reset button of NodeMCU, and you can see this dot, it is waiting for any Wi-Fi connection. And as the password was incorrect, so you can see it can't connect with the Wi-Fi connection. So thus you can easily check if the NodeMCU is connected with the Wi-Fi or not. Now let me do the same test with ESP32. So I will open the sketch for ESP32 to check if it is connected with the Wi-Fi or not. And here I have included this Wi-Fi.h. So you don't need to install this Wi-Fi.h separately. If you have installed the ESP32 board, then it is already installed. And again, here you have to enter your Wi-Fi name and a Wi-Fi password. Now I will go to tools, select the ESP32 board. For that I have to go to board, then select ESP32 Arduino, and I am using this Duet ESP32 dev kit module. So I will select this. After that you have to also select the proper port, then hit the upload button, and you can see it's showing done uploading. So I will go to the serial monitor and select the baud rate 115200. Now I will press the EN button of ESP32. It is searching for the Wi-Fi. Let me press the button again, and you can see it's showing the Wi-Fi is connected and it also printing the IP address. Sometime you have to press the button twice. Now let's discuss what are the common error that you may get during programming the NodeMCU or ESP32 board. This is the code for one of my previous NodeMCU project. So let me compile the code, and you can see it's showing error compiling for board Arduino Uno. So before compiling any code, first you have to go to tools, board, and select the proper board. In this case I will upload this code to NodeMCU, so I will go to ESP8266 boards and select the NodeMCU 1.0 board. So before compiling the code, you have to select the proper board, otherwise you may get this type of error. After that you have to check what are the libraries used in this code. Here you can see I have used Blink library. So you have to check whether the Blink library is installed or not in your Arduino IDE. For that you have to go to sketch, include library, and here you can see the Blink is installed. Otherwise you have to go to manage libraries, then search for the library. Here I am searching for the Blink library, and you can see this is the Blink library. So if you have not installed it, you can install it. In my case I will update it. So thus you can easily install or update any libraries which is required for the code. Now close this. After doing this, if I try to compile the code, I should not get any error, as I have already installed the required libraries and I have selected the correct board before compiling. You can see the code compiled successfully. This is another very common error that you might get during programming the ESP32 board. So let me show you how to resolve it. So let me hit the upload button again. Now whenever you see this type of connecting text, you can see this is the boot button of ESP32. So when you see this type of connecting text, just press the boot button for some time and release it. You can see the code started uploading. So thus you can avoid this type of error, and you can see it's showing done uploading. So the code uploaded successfully to ESP32. So these are some common errors that you may get while programming the NodeMCU and ESP32 board. If you find any other error, let me know in the comment section. I will definitely reply to that comment. So if you find this video helpful, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.